Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. Welcome to another Shopify tutorial and a how-to video. Again, a very demanding video from you guys where I received a lot of comments on my older video. And that old video was for adding a collapsible accordion. So that was the video where you can see it got 30,000 views till now. And I have been receiving a lot of comments on this video that you guys are having issues using the code available on that video. So I'm creating an update video for that because now you don't need to use any more code for adding collapsible accordion on your product page. So if you have a long product description, you can easily add collapsible raw, which is the section available in product page template. And I'm going to show you how you can add that. But the problem with that is most of you guys have been using it as a static content. So if you add that collapsible raw section in product template, it's going to show the same content for all of the products. But obviously you want the content to be product specific. So every single product should have its own description. And I'm going to show you how you can do that. And also I'm going to show you how you can hide that if those accordions or product rows does not have any content. So if you want to learn, make sure to watch the complete video. Pretty simple how-to video. You don't have to mess up with a lot of code. It's just a simple how-to video where you can learn how to lay out your product page in a beautiful way where it's not much lengthy and you can add accordion to make it look good. Okay, so as you can see, I have this product page here and I have these accordions, which is collapsible raw if you go to the customize settings. So that's the product page template, and here you can see we have these collapsible raw, what we call in product page template. But now the problem with that is that it shows the same content for all of the products. So that's the heading and that's the content within the accordion or rows. But if I go to any of the product, it's going to show me the same content. So that's leather case for AirPods and that's a different product. And if I go and check these accordions, it shows me the same content. And that's what we are going to fix by adding meta field. So we will map the meta fields with the heading of this accordion and for the description. And we'll also add a feature where if we do not have any content, it's not going to show the empty accordions to anyone, right? So let's start implementing that. By the way, if you are looking to add product slider like this, I have created a free tutorial on you can learn how to add this stylish slider for your product page. And there are multiple other tutorials which I have created in order to improve the layout, this transparent header you're seeing, the autoplay video, and this collection slider, and a lot of other sections just like this one. This is a lookbook section which I have created. And all of these sections are completely free to use. All you have to do is just subscribe this channel and watch the other videos which I have created. I'm also going to link in the YouTube video description so you can check out those tutorials. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to install a fresh DAWN theme and I'm going to show you guys step by step on how you can add accordions for product description, and it's going to show different content on different products. Okay. Now let's add a DAWN theme, and here we are on our theme sections, and I'm going to install a fresh DAWN theme, and the latest version of the DAWN theme by the time I'm creating this video is 15.2.0. and let's click on add button here. And guys, while our theme is being installed, there's a link in the description, so if you are new to Shopify and setting up your store for the first time, you can sign up through that link for just $1 a month. So if you're looking to sign up for your Shopify store for just $1 a month, make sure to sign up through that link in the description. Okay, our DAWN 15.2.0 has been installed. I'm going to publish that. So click on publish button here and then click on publish here again. Perfect. Now let's preview that. I'm going to close the old tabs here, and that's how our product page looks like. So if I open up the product page, that's how our product page looks like. And we are going to add the accordions here and we'll make it dynamic. So now let's go to the back end. And first, what we're going to do, we'll create meta fields for these. So let's click on settings. And then from settings, click on custom data. And then click on products. So I already have some of the meta fields showing up here due to the multiple apps which I have been using. So you might not seeing anything showing up here. And so avoid these here. So click on add definition to add a new meta field. And we will create two accordions with the dynamic heading and the description. So let's name this one accordion one heading. And let's select the type to be single line text, as our heading will be the single line text. And we can also limit the character count, and we can also add the regular expression, but we don't need that for now. Let's, after doing that, click on save. And now let's create the description meta field. Now let's click on add definition and then name it accordion one description. And from select type, we will need multi-line text. Perfect. Let's scroll down and hit save. Now we will do the same for the second accordion. Let's do for the description. And then click on save. Okay, now we have our dynamic meta field. We have a meta field created for products, which will show up on the product page here. So let's close this and go to any of the product page. So let's open this product here. And now when I scroll down to this product, we have this accordion one heading, accordion one description, accordion two heading, and accordion two description. Avoid these other meta fields which I have lots of different meta fields because I have created multiple tutorials related to that. So ignore that. Okay, now what we're gonna do, we will add collapsible raw in our product and map these meta fields to those. And how we will do that, let's go to online store. I'm going to open that in a new tab and let's click on customize. Okay, from here, let's click on this drop down and click on products. Then click on default products template. And here's our product. Now let's choose a different product because it looks pretty messed up. Okay, so let's check out this product here. So what we're gonna do, we will add accordions here and we will make this look good. So in order to make it look good, first, I don't like this stacked images, right? So in order to make it look good, what I'm going to do, I'm going to change the layout from stacked to thumbnail carousel. But as you can see, when I add thumbnail carousel, it's going to add the white spacing here. So let's click on save here. And when I go back to this product here, it's going to add an extra white space. It's not showing up because it's sticky right now. And the product description is too long. So we're going to make this product description a little shorter, right? So the page is not too much lengthy. And we'll also make this image a little smaller. So let's do that. So make this desktop media width to be small. Okay, looks much better. Now this description, we want this to be in accordions. Okay, now let's go to this part here. So that's the main product page template. So here, click on add block. And from here, click on collapsible raw. Okay, now we have accordions, or you can say collapsible raw is showing up, right? Now let's click on that. And now we will map our meta fields which we created from the heading in the description. Okay, now let's remove this heading here. Click on this icon here, which says connect dynamic source. And from here, click on this drop down here and select product. And from here, you can see that we have accordion one heading showing up. And I have added that. And now I'm going to add description here. And for that, let's click on this Connect Dynamic Source button here. And then again, click on this drop down, select product. And now we have accordion one description showing up. Perfect. Now let's click on save and do the same for the second accordion. And now let's do the same. I'm going to add another collapsible row and then connect it with my meta field. Perfect. Let's click on save. And now let's add content in these accordions. So this is Drop Classic Leather Wireless Charger product. And that's the product I'm on, Drop Classic Leather Wireless Charger. So I'm going to add this part on my first heading. So that's the description for the first one. Added that, and for the heading, information. Perfect. Now the second one, essential features. So that's the second heading, and now I'm going to add second description from here. So I'm going to just copy these bullet points and paste it here. Perfect. Click on save. And now let's remove these from the main description. So I'm going to remove that. Click on save. Perfect. Now let's check out our product page. Here we have information showing up. Here we have essential features showing up. Looks neat and looks nice, right? So you can make your product page looks nice and sleek by adding these accordions. Now the problem with that is it's going to show empty collapsible rows when there is no information on it. So if I go to any other product on my store, so let's suppose go on this product, you can see we have this description showing up here, but as we haven't added any value in the meta fields, it's not showing up anything here. So in order to fix this, in order to hide this, if we don't have any content, what we can do, we'll have to add a little bit of code. So let's go back to our customize, click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Guys, before editing the code, make sure to have a duplicate of your theme, because if you don't add the code properly, it's going to break your theme. That's a warning. So make sure to have a duplicate of your theme or save the codes before editing the code. Okay, now from the code editor, let's find out our main product.liquid file. Here it is. And from here, we will search for collapsible row. Collapsible underscore tab. So after this when, we will add a condition. If block dot settings dot heading is not blank, only then show this, right? So we want to display it when heading is not blank. When there is an actual heading, it's going to show this, otherwise it's not going to show. Now we will end this if before this when quantity selector. Let's end if. That's the small piece of code which you will have to add. What's it going to do? It's going to hide the collapsible rows which we added, the accordions. It's going to hide those accordions when there is no heading or content on them, right? So let's click on save and test it out and see if it works. Oops, I think we did a mistake in the code. Unexpected character. I think we did not equals to an issue if block dot settings dot heading. I think that's the correct way to do that. Let's try that. Yep. So that's the operator for is not equal to, right? So exclamation mark, then equals to. Perfect. Now let's test it out. Now here we don't have any heading on this collapsible tab. And now you can see it's not showing up, right? It's not showing anything below the description. Now here we have added the value of the meta fields and on information essential features. Now let's click refresh and see if it shows up. You can see it's showing up only when there is heading on those rows. It's not gonna show you anything when there is no rows, right? So that's it for the tutorial, guys. And before we go, I would like you guys to tell that we have launched a new app. So that's the app which we have launched, and the features in this app is that it's going to add a tiered discount feature. So if I open up this screenshot, you can see that you can increase your average order value. It's going to basically add automatic discount if someone adds more quantity to the cart. So if you have two products, you're going to offer 10%. If someone adds three items of the same product, it's going to add 20% discount. You can customize these discounts based on the number of product they add to the cart. It's going to increase your average order value and a lot of sales as well. And this feature is not available in default Shopify discounts. So make sure to try this app out. We have a free trial available. So check this out, install this app, and leave us a review on that app as well. That's it for the video, guys. Let me know if you want me to add in some more features. If you want to learn more about the collapsible rows and anything else other than that, make sure to let me know in the comments below. And until next video, have a great day.